فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
How did Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, or did how did deviated groups go against Ahlus Sunnah? صح؟ How did they? Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they said al-Imanu qawlun wa amal. The Iman is speech and it's actions. The Khawarij also said that al-Imanu qawlun wa amal. Just like Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. But their deviation came from this. They said that the qawl is asal and the amal is an asal. Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah said no. الإيمان قول وعمل إلا أن له أصلا وفرعا. ابن مندى mentions that in كتاب الإيمان. And also محمد نصر المروزي mentions in كتاب تعظيم قدر الصلاة. الإمام ابن القيم mentions in كتاب حكم تارك الصلاة. Also ابن تيمية mentions in his مجموع الفتاوى over 30 different places رحمه الله, which is the belief of أهل السنة والجماعة. And that is, إيمان has foundations and it has sub-branches. Things that if you leave the fold of Islam. That's known as أصول of أهل السنة. And the hadith of al-imanu bid'un wa sab'una shu'ba proves this. Look what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he said. What did he say? Al-imanu bid'un wa sab'una shu'ba. A'laha qawlu la ilaha illallah. That's aslul iman. Pay attention. The Prophet is going to divide. This is taken from the Prophet. This tatabbu' wal istiqra. Al-imanu qawlun wa amal. That the iman, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, al-imanu bid'un wa sab'una شعبة. أعلاها قول لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله is أصل الإيمان. Without it, there's no إيمان. You don't believe in Allah. Does that make sense? Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said, والحياء شعبة من إيمان. That's what? If a person is not shy, is he a disbeliever? Yeah? If a person leaves off shyness, is he a disbeliever? No, it's not. So this falls under كماله الواجب. This is known as what? Kamaluhu al-wajib, as Shaykh al-Islam Taymi mentions. The third one, which is known as what? Kamaluhu al-mustahab, which is what? Imatatu al-adha an al-tariq, taking harm off the ground. The Prophet is saying this, alayhi salatu wasalam. That's not wajib. That's what? Mustahab is recommended. Let me categorize you into three. Your heart is your asal, right? Is it not? If somebody stabbed you in the heart or shot you in the heart, would you live? You would die. The asal of your iman, based on the hadith, is la ilaha illallah. Are you with me, brothers? Then the second part is, if somebody cuts your hand off, are you going to die? But are you going to live a good life? You're going to struggle. And then it's wajib for you to have it. That's kamaluhu wajib. What about if you lose your hair? It's mustahab, it's beauty. You know, brothers who lose their hair, they just don't look beautiful, but they can still live, right? Or they look beautiful. That's the iman, brothers. Hadahu. That's exactly the iman. It's asal. If you lose it, you leave the fold of Islam. There's kamaluhu al-wajib, which is if you leave it, naqasa imanuk, walam yanqub imanuk. Your iman is decreased, and it does nullify your iman. And the mustahabbat also reduce your iman. وَلِذَلِكَ when we find in the Prophet's statements, عليه الصلاة والسلام, when he says, وَاللَّهِ لَا يُؤْمِنْ وَاللَّهِ لَا يُؤْمِنْ وَاللَّهِ لَا يُؤْمِنْ مَنْ لَا يَأْمَنُ جَارُهُ بَوَائِقَهُ. The Prophet said, Wallahi doesn't believe, Wallahi doesn't believe, Wallahi doesn't believe, the one whose neighbor doesn't find safety from him. The Prophet negated iman from this person. What is the iman that's being negated here? Are you going to make a person a kafir for not giving their neighbors their rights? And you say the Prophet negated iman from him. Yeah? It's kamaluhu al-wajib. The person's iman is reduced. It's like the statement of the Prophet ﷺ, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحبه لنفسه. Loving for your brother what you love for yourself. The Prophet negated iman. لا يزني الزاني حين يزني وهو مؤمن. صح؟ لا يزني الزاني حين يزني وهو مؤمن. That the believer does not commit zina whilst he's in a state of iman. Iman is being stripped here. صحيح؟ But what's being stripped here is not أصل الإيمان. It is what? كماله الواجب. But pay attention. Whenever iman is being negated from somebody, it can never be kamaluhu al-mustahab. Impossible. فتنبه بذلك. Be alert on that. That iman can never be negated and it's meant by kamaluhu al-mustahab. And then now we learn the first part, which is al-imanu qawlun wa amalun. We're now going to move on to the second one, which is yazidu bitta'a wa yanqusu bil-ma'siyah. Iman increases and it what? And it decreases. Iman increases and it what? It decreases. What does it increase with? Ta'at. And it increases with what? Ma'asi. ولذلك Allah says, الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسِ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إيمانا. الذين إذا ذكر الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. So that these are evidences to show that iman increases. Also, the scholars they say just like it can increase, it also can reduce. And that's the opposite of the understanding of it. Anything that can increase, then that means it was reduced for it to be increased. Sahih? So those are evidences for it. But there are other evidences we can give you. Where the Prophet ﷺ, he says, مَنْ رَأَى مِنْكُمْ مُنْكَرًا فَلْيُغَيِّرْهُ بِيَدِي فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِلِسَانِي فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِقَلْبِي وَذَلِكَ أَضْعَفُ الْإِيمَانِ. You see an evil, stop it with your hand. You can't. Stop it with your tongue. You can't. Hate it in your heart, that is the weakest of iman. Does that make sense? So the iman can become weak. So Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe that iman increases and it decreases. The third thing is that al-istithna. That you, when you say ana mu'min, you say insha'Allah. Ahlul Sunnah believe that. But when they say insha'Allah, they don't mean aslul iman. They are not doubting the asl of their iman. Did we not just categorize the iman into three? Aslul iman, kamaluhul wajib, kamaluhul mustahab. The insha'Allah is referring to the kamaluhul wajib and kamaluhul mustahab. And the reason why they do that and Ahlul Sunnah say, ana mu'minun, insha'Allah, I'm a believer, insha'Allah, is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَا تُزَكُّ أَنفُسَكُمْ هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنِ اتَّقَى. Don't praise yourself. Don't say, ana mu'minun. Plus, also, how do you know Allah has accepted this from you? إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. How do you know you're from the muttaqeen? Does that make sense? So Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, because of that, they say, أنا مؤمنون, I am a believer, insha'Allah. And their insha'Allah is not referring to لا باعتبار أصله, أي أصل الإيمان. Okay? Those three things, my beloved brothers and sisters that I've just mentioned, are what the issue Imam al-Bukhari is going to speak about. So now when we go into the book and we enjoy our time, insha'Allah ta'ala, this is the summary of it. Okay? Are you with me, brothers? Now, groups went against Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. I'm only going to mention those groups quickly, bi-ithnillahi al-kareem, and then we're going to go to the topic at hand, inshallah ta'ala. The groups that went against Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah are the Khawarij. What did the Khawarij do? The Khawarij, they said that every single person who leaves off any act of Iman, he's a kafir. Because everything to them in Iman is what? Asal. It's a foundation. It's fundamental. They put everything in an asal. They didn't make it aslun, kamalul wajib, kamalul mustahab. If they did that, they would not have made takfir of the people. Does that make sense, brothers? For them, the whole iman is an asal. Everything is an asal. So if everything becomes an asal for you, then what do? You make takfir of the person. That's what happened. As for the murji'ah, they took out actions out of iman. And they said that the iman is complete independent from the action. So the person who has qawlul qalb and qawlul lisan, for them is what? Mu'minun kamilul iman. He's a believer and his iman is what? Kamil. Does that make sense? So the amal, which is the action, is not part of the iman for them at all. Whereas Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they said it's what? It's part of the iman. Wa huwa juz'un la yatajazza. It is a part of it. It's a part of iman. Whereas they said, al-iman juz'un la yatajazza. The murji'ah say this, the mu'tazila say this, and also the khawarij say this, that the iman is a component. It's either found or it's either absent. There's no such thing as part of it's found and part of it's missing. They don't believe that. Whereas Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe if a person commits a major sin, he's what? He's mu'min bi imanihi fasiqun bi kabirati. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe what? He is what? Mu'minun bi imani. The iman that he has is a believer. But because he's committing zina, he's a fasiq for that sin. But we're not going to take the asl of the iman from him. He's still a believer. Are you with me, brothers? Within Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they disputed themselves. What should a person who's committed major sin, what name should we give them? Ahlul Sunnah differed. But they agreed on one thing, that the person is still a believer. They agreed. But they said, what term should we use? Some said, we're not going to give him iman as a name. We're not going to call him mu'min. So what are we going to give him? He dropped a level down, so he's going to be called a Muslim. He's still in the fold of Islam, but he's called a Muslim, not a mu'min. Some said, other groups said, no, we call him mu'minun bi imanihi fasiqun bi kabirati. He's a mu'min because of the foundation that he has. So he deserved that name because he came with aslul iman. Are you there? And he also, he's a fasiq because of the major sin or the sin that he's committing. Does that make sense? Whereas the Khawarij, they strip the person from it. Are you there, brothers? And the murji'ah, they took the action out of iman and they said that the iman is complete. وَلِذَلِكَ from the fasid, corrupted belief that come from the murji'ah is that a person's iman does not increase nor does it decrease. Are you with me, brothers? And so everybody here is iman is the same. Or no, all of us and the Prophet ﷺ's iman is the same. And no, all of us and the Prophet and Jibreel are all the same iman. ولذلك عبد الرحمن بن يحيى المعلمي he has a book called التنكيل بما في تأديب الكوثري من الأباطيل. He refutes محمد زاهد الكوثري الهالك. Who's refuted him? عبد الرحمن يحيى المعلمي. I advise you guys to buy his athar and to look at it. عبد الرحمن يحيى المعلمي mentions, he says, forget evidence, put that aside for now. Does it make sense to you that you tell an army person your iman is complete when he's committing zina, he's lying, he's cheating, you say your iman is complete? And another person's every day in the masjid crying, weeping, and he's told that your iman, is he not going to look at you and say, why am I burying myself like this? If the one in the club and me are the same. Okay, now, Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the way I explained it, do they differ on it? لا, they don't differ on it. ولذلك, ولذلك. Abu Qasim Hibatullah al-Lalakai in his kitab Sharh Usul I'tiqadi Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah, he brings ijma'at from the people, naqilul ijma'. Those who transmitted ijma' is Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i. Imam al-Shafi'i brings an ijma' that iman is qawlun wa amalun yazidu bi ta'ati wa yanqusu li ma'siyah. Walidhalik al-Imam al-Bukhari himself, what did he say? He said, laqitu, I met thousands of scholars from Kufa, Basra, Mecca, Medina, all of them, and he names them all. All of them were saying, Al-Imanu qawlun wa amal yazidu bi ta'ati wa yanqusu li ma'siyah. Now a question may arise from a person and they might say to themselves, okay, question. You're saying this is consensus and it's unanimously agreed upon. But we have some scholars who are Ahlul Sunnah who didn't take this, such as who? Hamad ibn Abi Sulaiman and also Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. So how do we reconcile between the ijma' that you're bringing and the qawl of Hamad ibn Abi Sulaiman and also Abu Hanifa who went wrong on this issue? The response that we give is that Al-Imam Abu Hanifa and also Hamad ibn Abi Sulaiman, both of them, they came after the ijma' was already there. So they went against the ijma'. The ijma' was from the time of the Sahabas until the time of Hamad ibn Abi Sulaiman and also the noble Imam, Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'a. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala commands us in the Quran, وَاتَّبِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا مِنْ دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ. Follow the commander, follow the Quran and the Sunnah. If a scholar goes against the Dalil, which one do we give precedence to? We give it to the Quran and the Sunnah. So the Quran and the Sunnah. And the scholars, they made an excuse for Abu Hanifa. And they also made an excuse for Hamad ibn Abi Sulaiman, rahimahumullah. And they are a'imma min a'immati ahli sunnati wal jama'ah. As Al-Imam al-Dhahabi mentions in the Sir Alam ibn Nubala and Ibn Taymiyyah in fi mawadi' kathira. Does that make sense, brothers? So don't let the ishkal of Hamad ibn Abi Sulaiman. Well, that what fascinated me while I was reading Kitab Sharh Usul I'tiqadi Ahli Sunnati wal Jama'ah was that Imam al-Lalakai was trying to point something. Do you know what he's trying to point? The quotes that he brings, that the iman is qawl and amal and increases and it decreases. Do you know who he brought it from, the majority from? What land he brought the majority of this view, that iman is qawl and amal and increases and it decreases? Guess who he brought the majority of the view from? Ahlul Kufa. Why Ahlu Kufa? Because he's trying to prove that Hamad ibn Abi Sulaiman and Abu Hanifa, they went against them, even their people of their own land. Ahlu Kufa. Does that make sense, brothers? He brought more naqal from Ahlu Kufa than he brought from Basra, Makkah, and Medina. And this is ka'annahu, Imam Abu Qasim ibn Abdullah al-Lalakai is trying to show you that this issue is what? The issue is for according to Ahlu Sunnah al Jama'ah is ijma'. Lam yantadih fihi kabshan. Two goats have not headbutted on this. So there's no issue, you can say that there's a khilaf of Ahlul Sunnah between themselves in the issue of what? Al-Iman. So now inshaAllah ta'ala, my beloved brothers and sisters, I'm now going to go into the Sahih al-Bukhari. You guys now have an understanding? Yeah? Yafaddal. So the brother's going to read for me in Arabic, and then the other brother, Abu Bakr, is going to translate it in English, and then I'm just going to point out little things that I see inside it.
قال أبو عبد الله محمد بن إسماعيل البخاري بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم كتاب الإيمان باب الإيمان وقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بني الإسلام على خمس وهو قول وفعل ويزيد وينقص قال الله تعالى ليزدادوا إيمانا مع إيمانهم وزدناهم هدى ويزيد الله الذين اهتدوا هدى والذين اهتدوا زادهم هدى وآتاهم تقواهم ويزداد الذين آمنوا إيمانا وقوله أيكم زادته هذه إيمانا فأما الذين آمنوا فزادتهم إيمانا وقوله جل ذكره فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا
جل ذكره
جل ذكره فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا. وقوله تعالى: وما زادهم إلا إيمانا وتسليما. والحب في الله والبغض في الله من الإيمان.
The Book of Belief, chapter, the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam: Islam is based upon five principles. And Imam Bukhari said, and belief is both saying and acting, and it increases and decreases. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the following verses concerning the subject. First, Surah Fath, Ayah 4, that they may grow more in faith along with their present faith. Surah Al-Kahf, Ayah 13, and we increase them in guidance. Surah Al-Maryam, Ayah 76, and Allah increases in guidance those who walk aright. Surah Muhammad, Ayah 17, and as for those who accept guidance, He increases their guidance and bestows on them their piety. Surah Al-Mudathir, Ayah 31, and the believers may increase in faith. Surah Al-Ali Imran, Ayah 173, and which of you has increased his faith? Which of you has had his faith increased by it? As for those who believe, it has increased their faith. And the statement of Allah, fear them, but it only increased them in faith. And also the statement of Allah, and it only added to their faith and to their submissiveness to Allah. And to love and hate for Allah's sake is a part of faith.
Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, as you can see, he mentions what I already spoke about, which is the issue of al-Imanu qawlun wa amal. So Imam al-Bukhari said here something different. He says al-Imanu qawlun wa fi'lun. So first of all, what did he chapter, first of all? Pay attention to this. I'm going to give you guys a beneficial qa'idah. We don't have to speak about every chapter of Bukhari. لذلك, that's what the scholars, they say, فِقْهُ الْبُخَارِيُّ فِي تَرَاجِمِ. You see how I said that? I specifically prevented myself from saying something. A lot of the people, they say, فِقْهُ الْبُخَارِيُّ فِي تَرَاجُمِ بِضَمِّ الْمِيمِ. And that is a lahan. It's incorrect in the Arabic language. It is what? فِقْهُ الْبُخَارِيُّ فِي تَرَاجِمِ. Because if you say فِقْهُ الْبُخَارِيُّ فِي تَرَاجُمِ and then you make a jama out of it and you say تَرَاجُمْ, it comes from the مَزْدَرُ التَّفَاعُلُ, which is the مَزْدَرُ الْقِيَاسِيُّ التَّفَاعُلُ. It will mean that you're throwing stones at each other. And that's not what we want from it. Do we? Is that what we want? Are we saying the fiqh of Bukhari is throwing stones at each other? Yeah? That's incorrect, it's not a language. صح? So we say فِقْهُ الْبُخَارِيُّ فِي تَرَاجِمِهِ. صحيح? بكسر الميم. That's an important point, and that we take it from the مزدر الرباعي القياسي. So we want to know a bit about Imam al-Bukhari's tabweebat, how he chapters his books. This is a qa'idah, memorize this and learn this, it will benefit you a lot inshallah ta'ala. Imam al-Bukhari, if he's talking about a matter which is ilmi matter, aqidah related, okay, generally speaking, what he does is that he brings the hadith itself, its wording in the bab. This is observation of Sahih Bukhari. Are you with me? Abdul Haqq al-Hashimi in his kitab, Lubul Al-Bwab. It's a seven volume book. Darul Nawadir published it. All it talks about is Imam al-Bukhari's babs. Bab. Just the sciences behind it. Six volumes. And Imam Abdul Haqq al-Hashimi, rahimahullah, just before I came, I managed to go through all of it. So Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, Imam al-Bukhari here, because he's talking about aqidah related issue, what does he do? He brings the taraf of the hadith, a part of the hadith inside it. But if it's a fiqh related chaptering, Bukhari will bring his own istinbat. Does that make sense? His own extraction or ruling, bringing out a ruling. He will bring a fiqh out of it. So here we're not going to find a lot of fiqh from his babs. Does that make sense? Because he's actually just going to bring the hadith binatsiha, its wording. Does that make sense to you, brothers? But if it's fiqh related issue, Bukhari rahimahullah, he will do istinbat and you will see his understanding in the bab. So right now I can't tell you that fiqh of Imam al-Bukhari in this hadith is nothing. There's nothing in there. Does that make sense? Also Bukhari, what he did was, if you look at the Sahih al-Bukhari, he says, وَهُوَ قَوْلٌ وَفِعْلٌ. And as we took before, we said, الْإِمَانُ قَوْلْ and what? عَمَل. So why did he use the word fi'l instead of عَمَل? Is there something distinct about this? No, there isn't. The fi'l and the qawl, Allah used them interchangeably. والله بما تعملون خبير وبما والله بما يعلم ايات which have been used the word يعملون has been used for يفعلون interchangeably in the Quran. More than 20 places in the Quran you find Allah uses يفعلون and يعملون interchangeably. So there's not really much fiqh that some people try to get out of this. There's nothing there. Then he said, which is the statement that concerns us here, because all the other points we spoke about that iman increases and decreases, is that he says وَالْحُبُّ فِي اللَّهِ وَالْبُغْضُ فِي اللَّهِ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. And this is taken from the statement of who? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Imam Abu Dawood narrated in his Sunan, بِسَنَدٍ حَسَنٍ عَنْ أَبِي أُمَامَةَ الْبَاهِلِيُّ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ مَرْفُوعًا. And this hadith, وَلَهُ شَوَاهِدٌ عِنْدَ أَحْمَدٍ. And Imam Ahmad has other shawahid that strengthen it. من حديث معاذ الجهني رضي الله تعالى عنه مرفوعا, which is من أحب لله وأبغض لله ومنع لله فقد استكمل الإيمان. Are you with me? من أحب لله وأبغض لله وأعطى لله ومنع لله فقد استكمل الإيمان. So anyone who loves for Allah's sake and he hates for Allah's sake and he gives for Allah's sake and he prevents for refuses for the sake of Allah, then that person has completed his iman. And also the hadith which also is narrated in Musnad Imam Ahmad بسندٍ ضعيف. The sanad is weak. But again, as we said, it has shawahid that authenticated from other riwayat, which is what? إِنَّ أَوْثَقُ عُرَى الْإِيمَانِ الْحُبُّ فِي اللَّهِ وَالْبُغْضُ فِي اللَّهِ. The highest branches of iman is what? Loving for the sake of Allah and hating for the sake of Allah. Naam.
وكتب عمر بن عبد العزيز إلى عدي بن عدي إن للإيمان فرائض وشرائع وحدودا وسننا فمن استكملها استكمل الإيمان ومن لم يستكملها لم يستكمل الإيمان فإن أعش فسأبينها لكم حتى تعملوا بها وإن أمت فما أنا على صحبتكم بحريص. وقال إبراهيم ولكن ليطمئن قلبي. وقال معاذ اجلس بنا نؤمن ساعة. وقال ابن مسعود اليقين الإيمان اليقين الإيمان كله. وقال ابن عمر لا يبلغ العبد حقيقة التقوى حتى يدع ما حاك في الصدر. وقال مجاهد شرع لكم أوصيناك يا محمد وإياه دينا واحدا. وقال ابن عباس شرعة ومنهاجا سبيلا وسنة.
Umar ibn Abdul Aziz wrote to Adi ibn Adi and he said, belief includes fara'id, enjoined duties, legal laws, and hudud, Allah's boundaries and limits set between lawful and unlawful things, and sunan, legal ways and deeds of worship. And whoever follows and acts on all of them completely has a complete belief, and whoever does not follow them completely and does not act on them, his belief is incomplete. And should I live, I will tell you about them so that you may act on them. And should I die, I am not anxious to have your company. And the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam said, but to be stronger in faith. And Mu'adh radiallahu anhu said to Aswad ibn Hilal, one of his companions, let us sit for a while so that we may dedicate that period of time to faith. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, yaqeen is perfect faith. And Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma said, a person cannot attain true sense of piety unless and until he removes all suspicions from his heart. And Mujahid rahimahullah said, he Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained for you, means, O Muhammad, we have ordained for you and him one religion. And Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu explained, a law and a clear way as Islamic way and sunnah.
Al-Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, he says, وَكَتَّبَ عُمَرُ بْنَ عَبْدِ الْعَزِيزِ. هذه من ناحية الرواية الإسناد. If we look at it from the angle of chain of narration, it's called معلقاً. And this doesn't fall under the conditions of Imam al-Bukhari رحمه الله. Remember when we spoke about Imam al-Bukhari الصحيح, what did we say? جامع المسند. This is not مسند, is it? Because we know Imam al-Bukhari رحمه الله, did he meet عمر بن عبد العزيز? لا, there's distance between them. Are you with me? So he narrating from him is called معلق. معلق is when Bukhari attributes a statement to someone, but he cuts out his teacher. This is called what? Mu'allaqan. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz's name is, his name is called Umar ibn Abdul Aziz ibn Marwan ibn al-Hakam ibn Abi al-As. He's tabi'iyun jalil. And he is Khalifatul Rashid wal Imam al-Adil. Now some people, they love Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, and without a shadow of a doubt, he was Imam al-Sunnah. Sunnah. But some people, what they do is they love, sometimes it takes them beyond the level, and they call Umar ibn Abdul Aziz Khalifatul Khamis. And this is incorrect for two reasons. For two reasons. The first reason why is because before him was Muawiyah. So if you say that the four Khulafa were Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman and Ali, then you make Umar Abdul Aziz the fifth, you're getting rid of Muawiyah, and this is Naz'a Rafidi. There's a Rafd here. There's that vein of Rafd that's coming here. Does that make sense? It's dangerous. It's as though you're trying to push Muawiyah like he was not of lots of importance. So that's one reason why we shouldn't call him Khalifatul Khamis. The second reason is because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Al-Khilafatu Situna Sana, Thalathuna Sana. The Prophet said that the Khilafah is how many years? Huh? 30, right? And if we calculate that and we look into it, we find that it ends at the ending of Ali ibn Abi Talib's Khilafah. Are you there? And some scholars, they said a couple of months after that. So then that couple of months after that would mean the 6 months of Hassan ibn Ali. Does that make sense? Because how long did Hassan ibn Ali have the Khilafah for? 6 months. So it would mean that it's the four Khulafa al-Rashideen plus the 6 months of Hassan. So then the Khilafah is over. So if you call Umar ibn Abdul Aziz Khalifatul Khamis, and the Prophet said the Khilafah finishes on 30, then you're trying to bring, you're lengthening it and you're making it longer than that which the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said. And then he goes, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, who did he send it to? Adi ibn Adi. He's a thiqatul faqih. He's a jurist and he was a man of knowledge and high caliber. And he was an amir. He was a governor in the land known as Mosul in Iraq right now. He was a governor there for Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. Umar ibn Tabi'in. He's from the great noble Tabi'in. What did Umar ibn Abdul Aziz say? Inna lil iman fara'id. What does it mean that iman has fara'id? What does it mean that iman has what? That the iman has fara'id. It means a'mal, actions, and matters which Allah has subhanahu wa ta'ala faradaha Allah azza wa jal, in which Allah has made obligatory. And then he says, wa shara'i'. Shara'i' is aqidah-related matters. Aqidah-related matters. Wa hududan means legislations. What's a legislation? Manhiyat, things which you're prohibited from. And ma'murat, things which are commanded, will fall under there. So manhiyat, things which you're prohibited from, and also things which you are commanded for, will fall into them. Wa sunanan. Sunanan is what? Mandubat and the things that are mandubat and the mustahabbat, things that are recommended. So for even Umar ibn Abdul Aziz's statement, you can find what? Aslul iman, kamaluhul wajib, and kamaluhul mustahab, he mentions that. فَمَنِ اسْتَكْمَلَهَا. Anyone who completes what? The fara'idh, the shara'i', and stays away from the hudud, and comes with the sunan. Anyone who does that, as it's needed from him, فَقَدْ اسْتَكْمَلَ الْإِيمَانِ. That person has completed his iman. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَسْتَكْمِلْهَا. And anyone who doesn't complete that by not coming with the fara'id and the shara'i' and the hudud, and he doesn't stay away from the manhiyat and the things which he's prohibited from, and he doesn't come with the sunan, لَمْ يَسْتَكْمِلِ الْإِيمَانِ. He hasn't completed his iman. So here, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz then says, he goes, فَإِنْ عَائِشْ. If I live on in my life, فَسَأُبَيِّنُهَا لَكُمْ. I will clarify it to you. حَتَّى تَعْلَمُ بِهَا. So you can know the furu' and the tafasil, the details, matters pertaining to this. I will explain it in more details. وَإِنْ أَمُوتْ. But if I die, فَمَا أَنَا عَلَىٰ صُحْبَتِكُمْ بِحَرِيسٍ. I'm not eager in your companionship. I'm not really eager to be in your companionship. Does that make sense? So, Al-Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, he did something here which we need to look at. He brought the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, which is what? In the chapter, did he not? He's brought Bunya al-Islamu ala khamsin. And we're talking about what, my beloved brothers and sisters? Are we talking about Islam or are we talking about iman? So why did he bring Bunya al-Islamu ala khamsin? That's Islam, we want iman. Brothers, you have to focus. When you're reading a book, you have to really look at it. Especially these books are not written. The imam wasn't just turned away when he was writing it. Sah? So why did he bring the hadith Bunya al-Islamu ala khamsin when we're talking about matter of iman? Some scholars, they said that Imam al-Bukhari is of the opinion that Islam and iman mean one. And there were some scholars who held that view. Such as from the scholars who held that view was Ibn Jarir al-Tabari and Imam Ibn Shihab al-Zuhri. They believed Islam and iman are one. The same thing. They are used interchangeably. Does that make sense? Some scholars, they said Bukhari is like that. But the truth of the matter is that he is not like that unrestrictedly. It's with more explanation that's needed. Are you with me? It's not just like that. Are you with me? Bukhari is of the opinion that we are of, which is what? Iman and Islam to us is the same. But when is it the same? It is when they are mentioned separately. إذا اجتمعا افترقا وإذا افترقا اجتمعا, which is what? If Islam is being spoken about here, it encompasses Iman as well. It means Iman here now. But if they're both mentioned next to each other, Islam becomes the outer actions and the Iman becomes the internal actions. Does that make sense? Just like the hadith of Jibreel, when the Prophet said, قال فأخبرني عن الإسلام. What did the Prophet tell him? The outer actions. He told him, As-salah, As-siyam, As-sawm, and Al-hajj. And shahadat Allah ilaha illallah. Does that make sense? But when he came to the Iman, he told him that internal. Al-Imanu billahi wa malaikati wa kutubu rasulu wa yawm al-akhir wa tu'minu bil qadari khayri wa sharri. So if they come together, they take different meanings. But when they're mentioned separately in different texts, they take each other interchangeably. Does that make sense? Are you with me, brothers? And one of the evidences that the scholars used is the hadith of Wafd ibn Abdul Qais. It's going to come to us, inshallah ta'ala. Where the Prophet ﷺ said to them, Atadruna mal iman? Do you guys know what iman is? And they said, Allah wa Rasulu a'lam. Allah and His Messenger know. And then the Prophet ﷺ said, Al imanu antashada an la ilaha illallah. Antashada an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah wa iqamis salah wa ita'i zakat wa sawm Ramadan. So here the scholars, they said the Prophet explained Iman to be Islam's definition. Did he not say antashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa rasulu? He should have said that, but he didn't. He said that atadruna mal iman. Do you guys know what Iman is? When they said Allah and His Messenger know, the Prophet said Iman is the five articles of the five pillars of Islam that they knew. So the Prophet defined the Iman to mean what he defined Islam to be. Does that make sense? And the Bukhari is going to bring that. So to say Bukhari believes that it's both of this, both of it is the same, that's actually incorrect. Then Al-Imam Al-Bukhari, Al-Bukhari rahimahullah, brings the statement of who? Ibrahim alayhi salam, Nabiullah Ibrahim. And I want you to pay here because this is a very powerful issue that sometimes doubts are brought to our youngsters. Which is what? Ibrahim alayhi salam, what did he say? He says to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, qala rabbi arini kayfa tuhyi al-mawta. Ibrahim, what did he say? This is Nabiullah Ibrahim. Arini, show me kayfa tuhyi al-mawta. How do you give life to the death? Sah? Allah then says to him, qala awalam tu'min. Did you not believe, Ibrahim? Are you asking me because you don't believe? Qala bala, I believe. Walakin liyatma inna qalbi, so my heart can find tranquility. Are you with me, brothers? So our Prophet came, and what did he say, alayhi salatu wasalam? He said, nahnu ahaqu bishakki min Ibrahim. Nabiullah Muhammad came, and he said, that I am more befitting to have more doubt than Ibrahim. Ibrahim will never have doubt of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. If doubt would come to somebody, it would come to me. This, the scholars, they say, this is not nafi. This is called ala sabili al-imtina'. Ala sabili al-imtina'. What does that mean? Just like you guys know me, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I will never doubt Allah tabarak wa ta'ala being able to create and knowing that Allah can do everything. Would I doubt that? No. You guys know me, right? Then if I can't, Ibrahim won't. That's more stronger than the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying that Ibrahim will not doubt Allah. Does that make sense? So for example, if I say to you, it didn't rain today. Pay attention, brothers, pay attention. If I say to you, brothers, it didn't rain today, what did I just say? I negated the rain not coming down today, right? This is called nafi. But can it rain? Could it have rained? Yes, it could have rained. If Nabiullah Muhammad said, Al-Ibrahim, Nabiullah Ibrahim, shak and doubt will not enter his heart, then we would have, somebody could still argue and say, but then that still doesn't stop him from having doubt. He could have it, he just maybe didn't have it that time. So the way that the Prophet could stop that, ala sabil al-imtina' is what? To say that even I, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do not have doubt of Allah. Let me just quickly just finish this. Should we just stop here? Okay, hey. The brother's putting pressure on me, so yeah, we'll stop inshallah ta'ala. We'll take a short break. And can this be the last break inshallah ta'ala? We have to finish the book because
inshallah we'll try doing that.